Why? Lwachi? It's a body that are widow. It's a body that are orphaned. Amen.
Amen.
Have you ever reached to someone? Made that someone? He's looking like an
orphan.
And he carried that person. Now expect a breakthrough. But if you have never done that, please, starting from now. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
Some of the men, after looking after the girls, amen. But the Bible says, Mordecai groomed that young lady and said, please, Atasha, you are no longer that name. Because Arasha means you are an orphan. You are a failure. Amen. You are helpless. But now you are Esther. Esther means you have to be a queen. You have to enter. You have to be favored everywhere. That's point number one. Number one. Number what? Number four. Come on, say amen. Tell your neighbor, point number four. Point number four. You need Mordecai. Point number four. You need Mordecai. And you, just point to that person and say, and you, when you are Mordecai, you have a breakthrough. And you are going to help you. I always tell people, children, because I've never raped
him
since my as I was born. So if God let anyone to rape my girl, I ask him so many questions because I've never done
it.
Amen. So when you are Mordecai, expect a bright future. Expect a breakthrough. Amen. He helped the orphan.
He helped
the orphan. Grew the orphan. Putting hope into the orphan. Amen. That's why our church is looking after orphans. Why? Because we know that's why you find that this church, many people fought against it, but they cannot defeat it. Because we have Esther's whom we are grooming to bring them to the future, supporting them. Come on, shout and say amen. God has to build this cathedral. Amen. Why? Because we had Esther and we groomed them. We put them into the future. Come on, say amen. Come on, say amen. We have two gents there in UK. They were orphaned. Amen. But we looked after them here. They were sleeping at the church, taking care of them, giving them hope. And one day, a visitor came from UK and said, can I invite this young lady?
He
said, yes, we want them to go. So they went. Now they are citizens. Amen. They are there. I don't care whether they don't remember us, because sometimes they come and they don't even pass here. But I know our God has remembered. He has remembered. He has recorded it into the book of remembrance. Come on, say amen. Come on, say amen. But when Ammon's a plan against you, that's when Mordecai sent a message. Number two, Mordecai had a heart of bringing life, keeping life, giving security. And that's why he saved the king. And one day when the king was opening the book of remembrance, he said, what happened to this man who saved the king? The Bible says, They called the king. They called the governor. He was promoted. Today, whatever you are doing, you don't need people to recognize you. It's called. Praise the name of the Lord. I don't hear you. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Five. Amen. The Bible says they brought so many virgin, beautiful young ladies. Amen. But Esther had confidence. Have confidence in you. You don't need somebody just to speak up for you. Always say I'm smart. Amen. Speak into the mirror and say, you look so beautiful. Oh my God, you look so beautiful. You look handsome. I'm the best. For me, I know I'm the best preacher. Because I know that when God is within me, I can preach better. Pastor so and so, Pastor so and so, Pastor so and so. But I think you have to be the first to preach. Amen. Because these are these generals. I ask you, who is the general? Tell me number one. Amen. Say who? Pastor Robert. No, Pastor Robert, we started preaching together. Even Pastor Robert is not my father. No, Pastor Frank is my father. He preached to me. But we started preaching with Pastor Robert. I don't care how he made it, but I'm on the way. He started with having. He was an interpreter with a badge. Amen.
Amen.
We had a lunch hour called Blessed God Ramon. Just on Kampala Road there. With his brother,
Makumbi.
Amen. That Bishop Makumbi is in the US. So he was an interpreter. I said, okay.
Yeah,
I don't care what he's doing. But what I know, he's a man of God. He's my mentor. Amen. When I was preaching, I was looking. On him. What is he? Come on, say amen. Number two, he told me, there is Pastor Sebana. I said, no, Pastor Sebana, I know him. I've ever preached with him in open air without even transport we used to walk. So when tell me the next one. So he told me all the others preachers. I said, I don't care for them. But I know I'm the best preacher. So he said, okay. Except him, you preach after them and you will see what will happen. Amen. That very day, Pastor Joseph Sebada preached fast. Then they called me. When they called me, I was already asked the Holy Spirit, what am I going to do? Amen. And the Holy Spirit was already guiding me. And I said, Lord, I don't want to speak my own. I'm not on competition. I know I'm preaching the word. Give me the word of the next to this pastor. So I started preaching. People, some of them you are getting out to stand in or outside. But I said, enter. One by one. And the old people were inside. I preached that preaching. Time. Never was that to happen. Do you know what happened? One man, he had one crutch. Amen. Amen. So I called him. The Holy Spirit told me, call that man. That's the only one
attention.
Amen. So the man threw the crutch and started walking. Oh, people, they started shouting. I went 1 hour. But I was saying, you will see. Because she was groomed by Mordecai. So she stood on that her tongue. Amen. She started walking majestically. She walked with confidence. She went to the king. Other people they did makeup. They started walking like catwalk. As they walked like a whatever. But Esther came confident.